Hi students, welcome back. Now let's see the pumping lemma for regular grammars or regular language, whatever you can. So what is this pumping lemma and how we are applying on this regular grammars? Let's see. So here there's a theorem. So let L be a regular language. So let's take L, the language L be a regular language. Then there exists a constant P. Let me take a constant in this language L. That is a pumping lemma. I have taken one constant P such that for every string W, okay, in language, mod W, that is the length of mod W, should be greater than or equal to this constant. Whatever the constant that is present in the language, that is the length of the string should be greater than or equal to P. Greater than or equal to P. Remember this point. Okay, in the pumping lemma, so if let we have taken a language L be a regular language, then there exists a constant P in this language such that for every string W in L, so in the language you will have a string, right? You know that the substrings are there. So in this language you are having a string W. That string should be the mod W, that is the length of that string should be greater than or equal to the given constant. Now, we can break this string into three substrings. Okay, let me take the W into three strings. X, Y, Z. Okay, such that it has to follow some conditions. That is a pumping lemma. Here, the mod Y, that's a positive number. Mod Y should be greater than 0. Okay, this should be greater than 0. And mod XY is less than or equal to P, means this type, this side is less than or equal to P, not the greater than or equal to P. Okay, here length, complete the length of the string, that mod M, mod W is greater than or equal to P, but here the mod XY is should less than or equal to P. And the third condition is for all K greater than or equal to 0, means I am taking one constant that is greater than or equal to 0, means above 0, then the string X, that is a 3, X, Y power K, Z is also in language L. So this is the theorem, it's a theorem of the pumping lemma. It's a simple thing. By seeing this, you won't be confused. Let's take a concept. If I taken a language L, that is a regular language, in that language, I'm having a constant P. Okay? And such that for every string W, here in the language you are having a string W. In W also you are having the P, right? So that should be mod W is greater than or equal to this constant. It should be greater than or equal to the constant. And we are breaking this into three strings, X, Y, Z. Such that, what is the condition on these three strings? Mod Y should be greater than 0. Mod XY should be less than or equal to P. And for all K greater than or equal to 0, the string XY power KZ is also in language. So let's see the proof, then you will understand. Before going to that, let me explain what are the different applications of the pumping lemma. Actually, why we are using this pumping lemma? What is the use of the pumping lemma? The pumping lemma is to be applied to show that certain languages are not regular. This, what is going to do? It is going to prove that some languages are not regular. Okay? What is the use of pumping lemma means? You have to say that pumping lemma is used to apply to show that certain languages are not regular. And it should never be used to show a language is regular. So you don't show this language is regular. You always take the contradiction. Show that certain languages are not regular. Okay, regular languages means no need to take that. If it is regular, okay, leave it. So, for some languages, you have to show that they are not regular. In that cases, you go for the pumping lemma. So, if L is regular, it satisfies a pumping lemma. Then no need to, you can't do anything. Okay, it's already regular. It satisfies a pumping lemma. If L does not satisfy pumping lemma, then it is not regular. Okay, so the thing is, the pumping lemma is applied to show that certain languages are not regular. Let me take the steps that are involved in the pumping lemma. So, if you see these steps, then you can clearly understood. To prove that, whatever the theorem I have taken, I am proving for here. The language that should not be a regular, that I have to be proved, that not regular. To prove that a language is not regular using pumping lemma, we have to follow these steps. If you follow these steps, you can see that the language is not regular by using pumping lemma. At first, we have to assume L is a regular. So starting, you take the contradiction. Let's assume whatever the language that I have taken, it's a regular. Next, so the pumping lemma should hold this language L. Okay, now this pumping lemma is holding this language L. So whatever the length it should be, it's holding the length L. It has to have a pumping length, say P. I said some constant has to be present in that language. Okay, that is a pumping length, say P. And all strings longer than P can be pumped to, that is mod W greater than or equal to P. That we know that. Now, find a string W. So now I need to find a string W in L, which is present in L, such that mod P should greater than or equal to P. So whatever the string that you are going to find out in the language L, that should be greater than or equal to P. That you have to be remember that. So after finding the string, you have to divide it into X, Y, Z. So whatever the string that you got, that should be divided into three parts. Okay, three parts. That is a X, Y, Z. Now show that, so whatever you have divided that string into three parts, and show that X, Y power I or N or whatever it may be, Z, that should not belong to the language for some of N. Okay, that N should be, I should be greater than or equal to 0. That should be, that you have to be remember that. Okay, the thing is, you have to show whatever the string that is divided into three parts, that string is divided and it holding an equation X, Y power K, Z, that should not belong to the language. Then you can prove that, it's already proved that the given language is not regular. If it belong to the language, then it is obviously regular, but we have to show it is not a regular. So this condition has to be followed. Then consider all ways that W can be divided into X, Y, Z. So you can check all the ways. Okay, I can prove this language as not regular. You have to check that. Then consider all the ways that W can be divided into X, Y, Z. Show that none of these can satisfy all the three pumping conditions at the same time. So you have to show that all none of these, whatever the condition is there, that satisfies all the three pumping conditions at the same time. Then W cannot be pumped, which is equal to the contradiction. Okay, so let me take the example, then you clearly understand how I can prove the language that it is not a regular. And I think this is using pumping lemma. In the next video. Thank you.